Seriously, Sean? Fuck you. Jesus.
Look on the bright side. No security to worry about.
And on the not-so-bright side, the slightest misstep means you're effectively paced.
Shut up, Sean. Almost there, Desmond. Once you reach the top of the lit-up crane, you should be high enough to make the jump.
Should?
It'll be fine. Don't worry.
Well, you might want to worry a little. I'm pretty sure she was high when she was running the numbers.
Sean!
A joke. It was a joke. Or was it?
Now, open your chute!
wasn't so bad.
So,
you must be Desmond. Not exactly what I expected, but I guess your kind doesn't have many options these days.
Who are you?
Ask your father. Now give me that.
I don't think so.
Look, I'm not supposed to kill you, but the boss man didn't say anything about fucking you up. So you got to the counter. Oh!
So who the hell is Daniel Cross?
Believe it or not, he used to be an assassin. The assassin, the way I've heard it told, but it turned out he was a sleeper agent for Abstergo, programmed to infiltrate and destroy the organization.
How did he know you were there? We could be compromised.
They must have caught me snooping inside their network and sent Cross to see what we were after. If they were aware of our current location, we'd know. Though, I will say this. It doesn't bode very well for future expeditions.
I've set up some cameras topside. If anyone shows up, we'll see it.
I'd suggest you go see about finding a socket for that power source. Or we can return to Connor if you prefer. All the artifacts in the world won't mean a thing without the key.
I know everyone thinks I'm being silly, but I can't shake the feeling we're being watched.
We are being watched. By Juno. Or some version of her.
Do you think it's a recording? Or is she a ghost? Or something else? Is she talking to us the way Minerva talked to Ezio?
No clue. I mean, who knows what else they were working on down here? There's still so many rooms we don't have access to.
But do you think she's, like, literally down here, waiting somewhere, still alive?
Still alive? That's mental. That I mean she'd be at least 75, 80,000 years old? Though powerful, yeah, but not that powerful.
They came down here looking for a way to survive. Maybe they found one.
Son, I owe you an apology. I shouldn't have lashed out like that. You have to understand, I've never been very good at this. Never mind that we live rather extraordinary lives.
Yeah, I kind of liked my ordinary one.
You can't escape who you are, Desmond.
So I've noticed.
Look, it's silly for us to go back and forth like this. I admit, I did a shitty job raising you. I apologize. I'm sorry. But it's important you understand it didn't come from a bad place. You're my son. I love you. I guess I was so busy trying to make sure nothing bad happened, I didn't consider the consequences. Truce.
Ah, Desmond. There you are. Can I ask a favor?
Maybe.
When this is all over, I'd like to try turning the dial back on the Animus. Like, all the way back. To the time of the first civilization.
You think it would work?
There was no real loss of fidelity when you visited Altair. Then again, that was about 1,000 years ago, and I'm looking at going back at least 70,000 more.
Sure, I'd be up for it. It'd be interesting to see what things were like back then.
Excellent. I think it would prove most enlightening.
I can't believe it's taken me so long to ask, but how's Mom? She's not...
No. Your mother is fine. We decided it was safer if we split up for this job.
Always assuming the worst.
For good reason.
Can I at least say hi to her?
I'm sorry, it's too risky. Maybe when we're done.
Right. When we're done.
Saved. We sought to face the sun's wrath and contain it. Four towers would be built to pull her fury into this place and dispel it. But even with all we knew, with all we had, it would take too long. 1,000 years we could labor and still the work would not be done. The first tower was never completed. The project abandoned. We moved on. But while we labored on other endeavors, a few returned. They thought to automate the process. Metal might finish what flesh could not.
Good luck, Desmond.
These are troubled times. The already uneasy alliance between the Crown and its subjects frayed. And behind them both, the Templars plot, pulling strings and moving pieces. History dictates they seek order through control. But how will they effect it here? Who supports them? And what conspiracies have they already spun?
Spare a moment.
All these things I must determine.
Of course.
For only by knowing my enemy can I hope to stop
him. What is it?
Xingbao, or Rope Dart, if you prefer. One of the many plans given to us by Shaoyun to...
Sorry.
We'll have to work on this.
Ganondogo.
Yes, my friend.
What brings you here? Is the village all right?
For now.
What do you mean? What has happened?
Men came, claiming we had to leave. They said that the land was being sold, and that the Confederacy had consented. We sent an envoy, but they would not listen.
You must refuse!
We cannot oppose the Sachem, but you're right as well. We cannot give up our home.
Do you have a name? Do you know who is responsible?
He's called William Johnson.
Where is Johnson now?
In Boston, making preparations for the sale.
Sale? This is theft!
Connor, take care. These men are powerful.
What would you have me do? I made a promise to my people.
If you insist upon this course of action, seek out Sam Adams in Boston. You'll be able to help. What have you done?
When my people go to war, a hatchet is buried into a post to signify its start. When the threat is ended, the hatchet is removed.
You could have used a tree.
What do I owe this great honor, Captain?
The letters you speak of, what are they?
Oh, now you wanna know. Captain Kidd's letters, boy. He hid a great treasure somewheres and sent letters to four of his crewmen along with a strange piece of leather. If you find the men, you'll find the scallywag. It's that easy, tis.
May I see them?
Ha! You might be a captain, but you're not too bright, are you? I'll barter with them. You give me some trinkets I like, and I'll give you a letter. Building my own treasure cache, see?
Trinkets? Like what? Where?
Use your imagination, Captain. There's interest and swag all over the frontier.
Yama.
What you got for me? Ah, you brought me some good pieces. That's worth a letter, to be sure. Here you go, Captain.
I will be back for the rest.
Connor, it has occurred to me that the times we live in will be looked upon by future generations with a certain degree of scrutiny, no matter the outcome. With that in mind, I think it valuable to record the goings-on around the homestead. A true log of how people lived during this time of transition. Something to help color the portrait. What do you think?
When I find a moment, I will try.
Very good.
Are you all right?
What do you think?
How did this happen?
Poachers in the woods. I asked them to leave. This was their answer.
Come on. We need to get that arm looked at.
What if the men who did this?
They can wait. Your wound cannot. You'll be able to make it to the house.
Yes. I think the ball took only flesh.
And what is your name?
Miriam.
Do you live nearby?
I don't have a home per se. I took to the frontier when I was a young girl. I made my life out here ever since. Living where the land makes it easiest.
Not a common choice for a woman of the colonies.
Nope, it's not. But truth be told, it was this, or the convent, or the brothels. I prefer the open air.
Kana! What are you doing?
Those poachers need to be stopped.
I saw the scabs from my hunting blind. Get to that, and you shouldn't have any trouble finding them.
Use the rope dart if you can. Get familiar with it.
few make a good haul up there.
I hear tell lumbering would be allowed, but what does he want with the territory if not the game? And I don't know. Don't much care neither.
No! I
think... Spare me!
Go! Tell the friends you have left what happened here.
Thank you, Achilles.
You are most welcome.
Why did those men attack you?
It's no secret this land is full with game. I spotted the trespassers en route to request permission to hunt here myself, and suggested they do the same.
The bounty of the forest is not mine to give. It is your right to hunt on this land, but I would appreciate you trading your surplus with the others.
Very well. I accept.
There he is. Hello, Connor.
You must be Connor. We've been raring to finally meet you. My name's Catherine, and this is Diana. We're the wives of those two blockheads who cut trees.
Nice to meet you. We've heard so much of you from the boys. Glad to finally put a face to the name.
The pleasure is mine.
We were just discussing how nice this bit of territory is, on a river, with nobody upstream. I won't lie, Godfrey's letter had me a little worried, but now that we're here and settled, I must say I'm rather happy.
They had us on this plot north of Champlain that was a tangle of rock and bramble. Ugh, horrible place. It's a real treat to be able to walk up the hill and take in the ocean.
Your husbands must keep you busy.
Nothing we can't handle, Connor. The boys think they run the show, but the real bosses are right in front of you.
I do not doubt it.
Nice to see you on this fine day.
We was 8 months in the Kentucky frontier trapping and skinning elk, well along my third bale when they came upon us. No less than a dozen Shawnee hunters had us surrounded at the point of musket and arrow. My bush partner froze up stiff. The fear chilled me the same, but I managed to muster what little Shawnee I was knowing. The leader spoke too quick, but I gathered we was poaching, having crossed into their territory a month or so hence. Their musket barrels stared us down, the heads of their arrows smiling sharp at our backs. I bumbled a proposition and busted Shawnee. Our full piece, my three bales, and my partner's two less a half, in exchange for us quitting the Shawnee bush on our own legs. Leader nods to his boys. They load up our take and start back into the trees. The honcho stays a spell longer, just staring. Staring right through us with his two black eyes. And then he was gone. We picked up, set back east the way we came. Months of profit lost, but our own hides intact. Never saw the Shawnee again, but I know they was following us. I could feel their eyes on our backs, clear to North Carolina.
Calma. Calma.
It stands upright, as a man, but its whole body is covered in a thick pelt. Its gait is slow and lurching. I've seen it with my own two eyes. It's clever. Always at a distance, or with something between us, like it knows where I'm gonna be before I get there. Things go missing where it goes, that much is certain. All manner of trinket. It took a man's prize buck antlers clear off his cabin wall. Takes kills out of traps, too. Wrenching him open with his big mitts. Somebody should find it and bring back its head for the whole world to see.
Yama. Yama. Thank you.
Okay.